Hello everyone, welcome back to another lecture of process modeling and simulation, and the module which we are covering these days is related to the distillation column. So far we have covered first three exercises of flash distillation column. In the first task we had simulated one flash separator. In the next task we had simulated three flash separators which were in series, and then the third task we had done the recycling. And if you remember, we had labeled our last flash separator as reboiler and the above two flash separator as stages. So this activity, the activity number 4, is related to the similar distillation column. Now why it is called a similar distillation column? Let me take you to the exercise. So this is the activity. This activity is related with CLO number 1, which is the basics or fundamentals of this course. CLO number 2 is related to the simulation of the equipment. Basically we are simulating flash separator in it. And number 3 is related to the flow sheeting. So obviously we are doing flow sheeting in this process. So this is the basic diagram which has been given to us. The fluid package is same. The feed conditions are again same. But what is the difference in it? Let me show you that if you see that S1 is entering this flash separator, which is B1. S2 is going to next flash separator, which is B2. S3, B3. Then S4 is the final outlet. S5, which is the vapor from this flash separator, is going to B2. S6 is going to B1 and S7 was the final outlet. This was our previous case, if you remember. But in this case, if you see, we have introduced two more flash separators over here. And then this third one. That what is going on? That the vapor from this flash separator is going to next stage. The liquid from this stage is going to B1. The vapor from B4, which is S9, is going to B5. And the liquid S10 is going to B4. Then this S11 is going to B6. And if you see, the S12 is vapor, while this S13 is split. One of it is getting as top product and the other stream is going back. So if you see, this is the condenser representation. Ye condenser ko show kar raha. Similarly, this one was our reboiler and this separator is showing as condenser, where the stream is entering. And it depends what type of product you want. If you want complete liquid, then this S12 will be 0. And all the liquid will go down to S13, which is split as per the requirement. And S14 will go back to the stage. Agar aapko thoda sa distillation ki basics mein agar jayein, to kya hota hai? Ki jo sabse top stage hai, usse vapor kidhar jate hain? कंडेंसर में. जब वो कंडेंसर में चले गए तो उसके बाद डिपेंड करता है कि आपने कंप्लीट लिक्विफाई करना है या पार्शियल लिक्विफेक्शन करनी है. अगर पार्शियल लिक्विफेक्शन करेंगे तो कुछ प्रोडक्ट S12 में चला जाएगा और कुछ प्रोडक्ट या जो रिमेनिंग प्रोडक्ट है वो S13 में चला जाएगा. ये जो S14 है, ये बेसिकली क्या है? ये आपका रिफ्लक्स है और ऑब्वियसली रिफ्लक्स आपकी टॉप स्टेज पे वापस आ रहा होता है. तो अगर मैं ये कहूँ तो ये 1, 2, 3, 4 चार स्टेजेस हैं इस कॉलम की. ये इसका रीबॉयलर है और ये इसका कंडेंसर है. तो अगर आप जब हम डिस्टिलेशन कॉलम में इसके बाद जाएंगे तो ये बिल्कुल वही चीज है, लेकिन इसको रिप्रेजेंट किया हुआ है कि एक फ्लैश सेपरेटर एक कॉलम की स्टेज को शो करता है. सो होपफुली आई थिंक थिंग्स आर नाउ क्लियर दैट व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड सिमिलर डिस्टिलेशन कॉलम. इन द प्रीवियस केस इट वॉज जस्ट अ रीबॉयलर एंड टू स्टेजेस, बट इन दिस केस देर आर 1, 2, 3, 4 स्टेजेस वेयर वेपर लिक्विड आर इंटरेक्टिंग. व्हाट आई एम सेइंग दैट लिक्विड इज कमिंग हियर, vapor from bottom stage is coming here, vapor to next stage is going, and liquid to below stage is going. And this phenomenon is happening on all these four stages. While on this stage, you see, this is condenser and this is reboiler. So we have been given that the duty of B4, obviously, just like B1, B2, B3, it will be 0. Similarly, for B5, it will be 0. However, for B6, we have to specify, because it is our condenser, that what type of product we want. If we want complete liquid, then I have told you earlier that vapor fraction will be 0. And if we want complete vapor, then the vapor fraction will be 1. And if we want two-phase mixture, then vapor fraction will be between 0 to 1. And we have been given that the molar flow rate of stream number 14, which is the reflux stream, which is this stream, S14, which is going back to the system. This S15 is now the distillate, the top product. This S12 is the top product and this S4. But since in this case, in B6, vapor fraction is 0, it means there will be no molar flow rate in S12. And S15 and S4 are our distillate and bottom streams respectively. So this value is 75 pound mole per hour. So without wasting any time, based on these specifications, let's quickly go back to the simulation. And I had told you in the previous case that save the simulation file, so you do not need to start from the scratch. And you see these conditions are same. B1 0, B2 duty 0, well, reboiler temperature is 143 degree Fahrenheit. So you see this diagram is already established. What we will do, we will go to separator and we will select another flash separator, which is B4, and we will connect stream S7 to it. And to make it look much better, I will simply move it here. And then what is going on? S8 is the stream. You can keep the nomenclature same or you can change it. It's fairly up to you. S8, this stream is going to this separator, and I can realign it. As you see, I have realigned it using this align option, and S9 is the vapor from this separator. And similarly, in the case of B5, what I will do, I will connect it. I will do the connection to it, which is the vapor stream, and then I will again align it, and S10 is going back to B4 and S11 is going to the top. If you see this B5, B4, B1, B2, these are the stages which say that there are four number of stages or there are five number of stages. So in the distillation column, this phenomenon is basically happening that these flash separators are connected and vapor liquid flow rates are established and so on. And the last one, which is the condenser, what we will do, we will do the connection. S11, S12 ke saath link ho gayi aur isi tarah aapne yahan pe isko link kar diya aur S12 aapka final out ho gaya iska. Similarly, S12 is the final out, then S13. And then we will install a split because we have to split the feed as we have discussed earlier. And the S14 is going back to B5 and S15 is our final outlet. So this is the complete network now. You see that this B3 is the reboiler. B2, B1, B4, B5 are the stages. B6 is the condenser. And to make it look more attractive, I will denote vapor stream with red color, liquid stream with green color. And you might be wondering how it can be done. Click on this stream in format, click on line and choose it as red. So you see all the vapor streams S5, S6, S7, 9, 11 and 12, they are denoted as red color, while the liquid streams are denoted by green color. Now we have already specified B1, B2 and B3. Now we need to specify B4. And for B4, the duty is 0, while the pressure is 14.7 psis. Since 0 specify means that the pressure will remain the same. So you can also specify 14.7 over here. It's clearly up to you. And then the same for B5, that it will be 14.7 psia and 0 BTU per hour. And for B6, we can specify the pressure, but we cannot specify the duty because in condenser, there is some condenser duty. Similarly, in reboiler, there is some reboiler duty. But for condenser, we have been given condenser vapor fraction is 0. It means here we will specify the vapor fraction as 0. So it's 14.7 psia and it is 0. So we have so far specified all the flash separators, but we have to specify this splitter. And how to specify this splitter? What to specify? We cannot specify split fraction because we have been given that the B5 14 stream, which is the stream number 14, which is, you see this 14 number stream, its smaller flow rate is 75 pound mole per hour. So what we will do, we will go to the split, and instead of split fraction, we will specify the flow rate, and it is 75 pound mole per hour. So after that, you see run button is active. Simply run it and get your required results. And you see results are now available. And if you click on this S12, then the S12 flow rate is 0 because vapor fraction is 0. There will be no vapor produced. Similarly, if you see this 11, 13, 14, 9, 10, 7, 8, 6, 2, 5, 3, these will remain in the system. The final outlets are 12, 15 and 4. So it means we have to specify 15 over here and 4 over here. And you see both are in liquid phase. Obviously, it will be in liquid phase, and these are the molar flow rates. And in mole fraction, you can see earlier you was not getting this much purity when you was operating with two stages and one reboiler stage. But now with four stages and one condenser and one reboiler, you are getting your required mole purity. Earlier, you was getting the mole purity of 64.95 or 0.6495, but now you are getting mole purity of 0.85. And if you increase stages further, you will see the impact will be more. Obviously, the flow rates will change in the system as that of the previous case. So that's how you simulate the multi-flash separator with the same configuration as distillation. Agar main aapse baat karun, iske baad jab hum distillation ko shuru karenge aur hum wahan pe specify karenge 10 number of stages ya 15 number of stages, to wo yahi hai ki wahan pe 15 number of stages specify karne ka matlab hai ki 15 flash separators hain, 20 ka matlab hai ki 20 flash separators hain, theek hai. Lekin ab usme ek cheez aapne zehen mein rakhi ki agar aap 20 specify kar rahe hain to usme se stages 18 hain, ek stage condenser ki hai aur ek stage reboiler ki hai. ये आप लोगों ने जहन में रखना है कि अगर आप फॉर एग्जांपल न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व कर रहे होते हैं तो उसमें आप कहते हैं जी 30 स्टेजेस हैं, तो उसमें आप उस टाइम रीबॉयलर कंडेंसर नहीं कंसीडर करते, अगर करते भी हैं तो उसके आधी आधी स्टेज कंसीडर कर लेते हैं, ठीक है. तो वो 29 स्टेजेस होती है और बाकी आधी स्टेज कंडेंसर की और आधी स्टेज रीबॉयलर की होती है. लेकिन इस केस में क्या है कि ये B6 आपकी कंडेंसर की स्टेज है और B3 आपकी रीबॉयलर की स्टेज है, तो टोटल इस सिस्टम की 6 स्टेजेस हैं, लेकिन असल में स्टेज चार एक कंडेंसर को शो कर रही है और एक रीबॉयलर को शो कर रही है. तो इस चीज को आप लोगों ने ज़हन में रखना कि जब हम बात करेंगे एस1 प्लस के अंदर कि मैं स्पेसिफाई करूंगा स्टेजेस एट 20, तो वो टोटल 18 स्टेजेस हैं, उसमें कंडेंसर की एक स्टेज है और रीबॉयलर की एक स्टेज है. सो दैट्स हाउ यू डू इट एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल मूव टू शॉर्टकट डिस्टिलेशन कॉलम. सो थैंक यू फ्रॉम दिस लेक्चर.